This is Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we will define the linear momentum of a particle. Solve an example about the calculation of the linear momentum of a particle. Define the linear momentum of the center of mass of a system. And finally, solve an example about the calculation of the linear momentum of the center of mass of a system.
Definition of linear momentum. Watch this elephant moving at a low speed. Why is it so hard to stop the elephant? And the answer is, it has a large mass. Watch this bullet. And the same question. Why is it so hard to stop the bullet? And the answer is, it moves at a high speed. We conclude from these observations that mass and velocity of an object play a major role in studying its motion. The product of these two quantities represents a physical quantity called the linear momentum of the object. So here we want to start with the linear momentum of a particle. It is given by P is equal to m times v, where p is the linear momentum, m is the mass of the particle, and v is its velocity. Now, you know that the mass is a positive quantity. This means that the velocity and the linear momentum have the same line of action and direction. Now, let's move to the units. In SI units, P is expressed in kilogram meter per second, and M in kilogram, V in meter per second.
Let's solve an example on the linear momentum of a particle. A particle of mass 500 gram is launched with an initial velocity V0. The magnitude of V0 is 10 meters per second, and it makes an angle alpha equal 60 degrees with the horizontal. At the highest point A, the velocity of the particle is VA, which is parallel to the horizontal axis and has a magnitude of VA equal 5 meters per second. VA parallel to the horizontal axis, that means VAY is equal to 0, or VA has no component along the y-axis. Determine the linear momenta of the particle and their magnitudes at points O and A. Momenta is the plural of momentum. Here we have four questions. PO vector and its magnitude at point O, PA vector and its magnitude at point A. Now let's start with point O. First, we have to determine the expression of the velocity at O. VO equal VOXI plus VOYJ. VOX is the horizontal component of the velocity at O along the x-axis, and VOY is the vertical component of VO along the y-axis. See the figure. In the right triangle, cosine alpha equal VOX over V0, or equal adjacent over hypotenuse. So VOX equal VO cosine alpha, and sine alpha equal VOY over VO, or sine alpha equal opposite over hypotenuse. Then replace VOX and VOY by their expressions. So VO equal VO cosine alpha I plus VO sine alpha J. Now replace VO and alpha by their magnitudes, which VO is 10 meters per second and alpha equals 60 degree. Finally, the expression of the velocity at point O equal to 5I plus 8.660J. Using the formula, VO as a vector equal the mass times the velocity at point O. Now, substitute for m equal 0.5, VO equal 5i plus 8.66j. Finally, we get VO vector equal 2.5i plus 4.33j. Now, to determine the magnitude of the linear momentum at point O, just multiply the mass of the particle by the speed at the point O. So PO as a magnitude equal MVO equal 0.5 times 10 equal 5 kilogram meters per second. Note The magnitude of PO can be calculated using another method, which is the norm of this vector, 2.5i plus 4.33j. The norm of this vector, or the magnitude of this vector, is given by radical 2.5 squared plus 4.33 squared. At point A, PA vector equal the mass of the particle times its the velocity at point A. So PA equal 0.5 times 5i. As I said, VA has no component along the y-axis, so VA as a vector equal 5i. Finally, PA as a vector equal 2.5i kilogram meter per second. So its magnitude equal to 2.5 kilogram.
Focus, please. This is important.
Let's move to the linear momentum of a system of particles. Consider a system of n particles. So we have the first particle of mass m1 and linear momentum p1, the second particle of mass m2 and linear momentum p2, and finally the nth particle of mass mn and linear momentum pn. Now, the linear momentum of a system of particles is given by this formula. P system is equal to p1 plus p2 and finally pn, which is equal to the vector sum of the linear momenta of the particles. As you know, p1 is equal to m1v1, p2 is equal to m2v2, and finally pn is equal to mnvn. Now, replace p1 and p2 and pn by their expressions. This is going to be P system is equal to m1v1 plus m2v2 and finally mnvn. Now let's move to the linear momentum of the center of mass of a system. Now we denote G as the center of mass of our system. Recall that the position of the center of mass is given by this formula. Rg is equal to m1r1 plus m2r2 and finally mnrn over m1 plus m2 plus mn. R1 is the position vector of the first particle relative to the origin of the Cartesian frame of reference. R2 is the position of the second particle, and so on. Now, we will deal with particles of constant mass. So if we want to differentiate the last equation with respect to time, you will get Vg is equal to m1v1. You know that v1 is the derivative of r1 with respect to time. Similarly, v2 is the derivative of r2. So finally, we have the velocity of the center of mass. Now we have the velocity of the center of mass, Vg. Take capital M as the sum of the masses m1, m2, and mn. Now replace m1 plus m2 plus mn by capital M. You will get Vg is equal to m1v1 plus m2v2 and finally mnvn over capital M. Rearrange. This is going to be capital MVG is equal to M1V1 plus M2V2 and finally MNVN. Now let's examine the two sides of this equation. Let's start with the left side, MVG. What is MVG? MVG is the linear momentum of the center of mass. And look at the right side. What does the right side mean? The right side is the linear momentum of the system of particles. So this is going to be finally PG, the linear momentum of the center of mass, is equal to capital M, the mass of the whole system, times VG, the velocity of the center of mass. This is equal to P system. The conclusion: the linear momentum of a system of particles of constant mass is equal to the linear momentum of the center of mass of the system.
Solving an example on the linear momentum of the center of mass of a system. The figure shows two marbles A and B moving horizontally in opposite directions. Marble A has a mass of 50 grams and moves with a speed of, say, of 4 meters per second, whereas marble B has a mass of 75 grams and moves with a speed of 6 meters per second. We assume that marble A moves along the positive direction, whereas marble B moves along the negative direction relative to the shown x-axis. Question number one. Determine the linear momentum of the system AB. The linear momentum of the system can be given by P1 plus P2, where P1 is the linear momentum of marble A, and P2 is the linear momentum of marble B. Now, P1 equal M1 V1 and P2 equal M2 V2. But M1 and M2 are given in gram. In order to get the SI unit of the linear momentum of the system, the two masses should be substituted in kilogram. So 50 gram is equivalent into 0.05 kilogram and 75 gram is equivalent into 0.05 kilogram. So substitute for M1 0.05 kilogram, V1 equal 4i, since M1 moves along the positive x-axis, M2 0.075 kg and V2 equal minus 6i, minus, as I said, since M2 or marble B moves in the negative direction. So P system equal 0.2i minus 0.45i. Finally, we get P system equal minus 0.25i in kilogram meters per second. Part 2. Deduce the velocity of the center of mass of the above system. Using this formula, the linear momentum of the center of mass of a system equal to the linear momentum of the system. So, m times vg, where this m is the total mass of the system, which is m1 plus m2, and vg is the velocity of the center of mass to be determined. So, vg equal minus 0.25i over the total mass, which is m1 plus m2. Finally, we get vg equal minus 2i in meters per second.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.